let us discuss about charging current in a given RC circuit. Here there is a similar circuit which we have discussed in previous sections. And here if at t equal to 0 we close down the switch, the battery supplies a current which decreases with time as charge on capacitor increases. And we already obtained that capacitor charge is given as CV1 minus E2 power minus T by RC. Now in this situation, if we calculate the value of the current supplied by the battery during charging of capacitor, which is called as charging current. So we can say current during charging of capacitor is, this current we can write as dq by dt. If we just differentiate this expression, you can see what we are getting. It will be V by R e to power minus T by RC. This is the expression for the current which is responsible for charging of capacitor. And if we just plot a variation curve with time for the current, here you can see at t equal to 0, the value of current we are getting is V by R. And at t tending to infinity, or we are talking about steady state after a long time, you can see at t tend to infinity, the value of current will tend to 0. That means at t equal to 0, the value of current was V by R, and gradually it's dropped down according to an exponential curve, and finally it decreases down to 0. This is the way how the current varies in the circuit, and as current is going down, the charge of capacitor is increasing to its steady state value. There are some more facts here. You can see that at t equal to 0, just after closing the switch, here if you have a look on the value of current, it is V by R, as if the capacitor is behaving like a straight wire or just as a short circuit. Always remember, whenever in RC circuit the switch is just closed, an uncharged capacitor behave as if it is a short circuit wire in supplying the current in the circuit by the battery. This concept we are going to discuss in detail later also. As just now we have calculated that in charging of a capacitor through a resistance and a given RC circuit across a DC voltage source, the charging current is given by this expression, and the charge on capacitor as a function of time is given by this expression. Using these values, we can find out various parameters of the circuit, like if we calculate the potential difference across capacitor as a function of time, this can be directly given as potential difference as a function of time will be Q by C, and Q as a function of time is given by this value, then it can be written as here C cancelled out. It will be V1 minus E2 power minus T by RC. Similarly, if we calculate the potential difference across resistance as a function of time, then potential difference across resistance as a function of time, this potential difference across capacitance as a function of time, this can be written as simply IR, because if I is the current flowing through the resistance as a function of time and R is its resistance, it can be simply given as IR. So if we substitute the value, it can be seen that the value will be V e to power minus T by RC. Here you can also add these two values, and you can see we are getting the value of battery EMF, because the sum of these two potential differences must be equal to the potential difference across the battery, which is its EMF. Similarly, we can calculate the energy stored in capacitor as a function of time. This energy UT can be written as Q square by 2C. At any time, if charge in capacitor is Q, it can be written as Q square by 2C. If we substitute it here, a value of Q, if we just square it, it will be C square V square. And 1C gets cancelled out, so the result will be half CV square 1 minus E to power minus T by RC whole square. Similarly, if we calculate the thermal power in resistance as a function of time, And this thermal power as a function of time can be written as I square R. So the value of I we are already having. If we just square it and multiply with R, you can see we are getting V square by R multiplied by e to power minus 2t by RC. That is the thermal power produced in the resistance as a function of time. Sometimes we are also required to find the rate of storage of energy in capacitor that can be obtained by time derivative of this energy. Like this, we can calculate all the parameters related to capacitor or resistance in the series RC circuit during its transient analysis or during the charging of capacitance, as we already obtained the time functions of current in the circuit and charge on capacitor.